people, some of you have eaten and will be sleeping at 10. No? Fine, okay, you salad something light, okay? Study for you can see how. Well, we're going to open with a word of prayer. We have now today here, I think, four pastors here in the room, is that right? We have Pastor Young, we have me, Pastor F, Pastor Tyler Fairness, and we have the assistant community youth, right? And you have not yet written. So, good opportunity, you can come to pray, and I will interpret, okay?
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for this day, and thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be here, Lord. It's a great pleasure, Lord, to be able to share this day, Lord, with our brethren, and be able to, Lord, also learn, Lord, about the depth of ministry, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those who you have called, Lord, to minister in this area also, Lord, and I pray that you also open the hearts, Lord, to any of our teens, Lord, or anybody else who might also want to use in this ministry, Lord. Thank you again for the privilege of being here, and thank you, Lord, for all you do for us. Thank you for the food that we had too today, and I pray that you bless the rest of this day. In Jesus' name, I ask.
All right, we're a little bit postponed with the schedule, okay? So just to explain with you, our teen group needs to leave at time 2, right? Okay, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to let them sing with us. We'll interpret that. I know that saxophone's a little bit hard to interpret, so we'll see how to match together. But we have some hearing people here in the room also, okay? So we give benefit, and also we want to give opportunity to express from their cultural view, same as our deaf culture up until now. They've been waiting patiently for their time for that. And so we really appreciate Pastor you inviting you to come, also for you preparing and being willing to serve in different areas. Our deaf people really, really appreciate that. Time 2 o'clock. I'm going to just hold it. I'm going to say stop, time out, whatever happens. We'll give an opportunity to leave. We'll settle again. If people are outside trying to watch from the trees or from the windows, they come in closer after that time period. It will be a small family again. This is fine. Okay? So are we ready for some music? Okay. And which is the first one?
First we'll play instrumental, and then we have a song. Okay.
And what's the name of the instrument?
This one is Beat Out Migration.
Okay.
Very good instrument.
So I'll go ahead with the first verse and I'll take 10 minutes and I'll do that. And the
words are...
Second stance in Spanish and other.
Okay. So we're going to need to be both here, I guess, because you told me the second verse is in Spanish.
Okay. Which song?
It's Rejoice in the Lord.
Rejoice in the Lord. Okay. Rejoice in the Lord. Do you want to do the English part? Test again. Yay. have studied engineering before, and I know there's a plus and a minus, okay? So I took it apart and I looked, and it was flipped around, okay? An easy mistake for someone to sell that way. Yeah, we'll blame the store, right? No, we'll blame me. I should test before church. Anyway, my wife is wonderful. Really, born five children, boy, that's enough to bring, right? But when I had suggested our theme verse, what's our theme verse? Tell me. Ephesians chapter 5.
Verse 8, right?
Good, verse 8. And what's it talk about? Blessed? No, that's
walking
Matthew.
Walking in light.
Yeah, you were in darkness before. That's good. That's concept related to darkness before. Okay.
Walk as children of light.
Same as Psalm chapter 23. You remember we have the valley of darkness. It doesn't matter if we're there. The Lord is with us. Okay. So now. Yeah, and we have the feet with the light. Jesus Christ, that's good feedback. Good. So now our theme verse is talking about walking, not in darkness in the world's way, but in the light, in Christ's light. And we need to think about that. So I gave yesterday one award, right? Dennis, raise your hand. He won yesterday, okay? Today, I started with some children, and then I advanced to some teens, and my wife had an idea. So when she went to the store recently, she told me, I have some more awards to add to resolve the problem. I had too many. So there were four teens who came. There were two girls and two young boys. Let's see here. Where's my list? Okay. So who, raise your hand, who was the teens? Were you one of them? Okay.
Yes. Okay.
And there's two more.
Esther.
Oh, Esther. She's gone. Oh, she's here, okay. And one more boy. Who's the shy one?
Lenny.
Okay, good. Okay, so we have four. Now, I'm going to let you decide which you keep, okay? You four can decide and divide, okay? Because my wife invented an idea. Now, I know you don't want the last gift, okay? So we'll save that for later, okay? That's a light for special, okay? We have some candles also, okay? So we have two, and we have two, okay? So we can divide them. You guys can decide how to divide, but I'm going to give all four. You did a good job together. And one teen asked me the reason why I was collecting the names of who the teens were here. Okay, now I don't plan to steal your teen, okay, Pastor? I will plan tomorrow at time 4 o'clock to project the names of the teens who served here through our prayer service, okay?
Oh,
because I want you to understand my heart for them. Every year we go and we teach sign language, basic, 100 religious words for children, kindergarten through fifth grade. So Martha, raise your hand. Okay, Jesse, raise your hand. Eva, raise your hand. Ken, raise your hand. Richard, raise your hand. Who other has volunteered before the Chinese school? Okay. See, those deaf people go with me, and we teach each year about 200 students, kindergarten through five, about 100 religious words. Why? Because our heart, we want to see the gospel spread. Okay. Now he tells me we have maybe 10 hidden secret churches in China. We praise the Lord. I want to see that. Okay? We don't know who is there. But we are going to be training the next generation. And you, youth group, okay? So your names will be shown up here. We'll be praying you don't fall to temptation in the darkness. That you don't follow the influence of who is bad in the community. It doesn't matter English or Spanish community. Both have wicked people. Okay? doesn't matter deaf and hearing, we both have sin, okay? But we will continue to be praying for you to influence the world with the light of Jesus Christ, okay? So that's the reason why I collected your names. I'm sorry if you were hoping it was for the prize. Oh, he tells me prayer is better, and that is right. Amen. Okay. All right. And also, I want to go ahead and invite our pastor to come and use about 15 minutes now. And then remember, we need to hold and let the team group leave. So you decide how to best use the time before.
Maybe this topic is 15 minutes.
You can condense, or you can start and decide how to land it, and then take off again and land a second time later. Okay.
Can I sign in new voice?
Yes.
Is that all right? Okay.
I want to be able to see you now. Do you want the pictures? Okay, now when we preach,
Jesus, when he was preaching,
traveling, he was near to the water. The lake. And all the people, they gathered around, crowds of people, and they looked, and there was boats, two of them, that approached. And the people that were controlling were fishermen. And they were washing with their nets. So Jesus spoke. In your boat, I want you to go out there. I'm going to preach and teach the people. So Jesus,
preach
and talk, and then finished, he said, Peter, take the boat and go out deep. Go out to the deep water. Launch deep. Why? Well, remember, they have their fisher nets, which they cast them out, and then the fish would get gathered up. I don't understand. All morning, we have been fishing already. We've been throwing out the nets, and there's no fish there. But suppose, if you tell me, it's okay. I will obey, said Peter. Wow. And you and I, we need to have that same attitude. If God tells us to do something, we need to say, yes, sir. So they rowed out. They cast out the nets. And the fish came and swarmed around. They gathered them up, pulled them in. Wow, fish, so many. How? What do? They kept gathering and gathering. And then the nets started to break. What do? This other boat, remember? We had two boats. We have a partner over there. Come on, partner. Help us. Come on. Fast. So they gathered up. And then they're pulling the fish into the two boats. And so then Peter now, he looks up. And he understands who is Jesus. He bows down and says, me, I'm a sinner. Hold on. Go away from me.
Hold on.
Right now.
Beg me.
It's all right for you to come. And the two boats came together. They came up to the beach. And the people got out and all followed, all the followers, excuse me, of Jesus had a choice. They could decide to follow Jesus and all the things that they had, the fish, the business materials that they had for going fishing, the boats, ships rather, the nets, parents, maybe all the business before.
I tell you.
Thank you, Mother, Father, thank you. But I'm going to follow Jesus. Jesus said, now, I'm sorry, before, the fisherman. But now you're not going to fish for little fishies, you're going to fish for big people. You're going to search for people to preach the gospel about Jesus. And Jesus, a Savior. Jesus will be preached as the Savior. It's interesting. Jesus said, go to the water deep. The water deep. Dangerous. If the water is here, just up to my ankles, it's all right. But if I go deeper to my knees, and I go to my waist, and I go to my thighs, or my chest, up to my neck, I'm going to go down and drown. It's dangerous. Jesus said to us, you need to step out by faith. Trust me. It doesn't matter if it's dangerous. I will be helping you. Remember, it was acting. Someone was acting about Jesus, how he was walking on the water, the wind and the storm. Do you remember that? And Peter, he saw him. And he jumps out, and he walks out to meet him too. Wow. That's a miracle that's been worked. But when we start to doubt, Peter starts to sink. But Jesus grabs a hold of him and saves him. Jesus always saves you. It doesn't matter if it's dangerous. It doesn't matter if it's hard time. It doesn't matter if it's trouble, problems, it's always saving for you. He wants people to step deep into the waters. The problem that you and I maybe we've not yet launched. We're on the beach here. I'm safe here. I can watch the water. I'm safe. But Jesus wants you to step out. It's chilly out here in the water. Maybe you are standing right here on the water line, right in your ankles, and you need to step out a little bit deeper. To step deeper. Step deeper. Up to here. It's over my head now. Jesus will save you. Jesus will help you. We've been waiting a place of safety. But if a person who's walking by faith, trusting Jesus, Jesus wants you to step out into the deep. Dangerous. Maybe to a place where people mock you, abuse you. Safe and out of the comfortable. And God wants you to go ahead and step and to serve Him, to obey Him. Deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. And you just yell, "Help me," and He will. He will. You're all right. You need to trust Jesus every day. It's going to be, it's not sin to trust in Jesus. Touched his heart, and he stepped out in faith, and he started to learn sign language, and he obeyed God. You and me are the same. I'm too old. I'm kind of saying God touches my heart, but I obeyed. Person asked me, "Kurt, you're so old. Why do you start now studying sign language?" So I answered, "Do you want me to argue with God? Who wins? He always wins." So it's easy, just I surrender. I'll serve you. It doesn't matter. You and I, we need to be the same with our attitude. It doesn't matter. Here, deeper, into the places that are dangerous, it's all right. He is always going with us. That's the way to serve Him. Let Him lead us. I'm going to pray. Father, we do thank you. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your help. We pray now. Many, many people here have decided, Lord, I want to follow. It doesn't matter if, how deep it goes, how dangerous it is. It doesn't matter if there's people that abuse me. It doesn't matter if there's people who mock me. I will serve you. I will obey you. Use me. If you want me to serve you as a missionary, it's all right. Take my life now, and I pray in Jesus' name. Okay, we have one preaching left, but for teens, thank you for coming again. We're going to let you leave, and then we're going to set up again for the last class and also make a place for the children. Okay? Hey, pay attention. She wears whistling. She says, women, you're free. Come, pay attention.
Miss Lori and Miss...
Stop, same. No, it's not your place.
Samuel.
We have a special for two people, brothers and sisters in Christ, in the house of friendship here. We just have enjoyed our emphasis today. For here and here, we have, I brought some cake, a little late happy birthday for you two girls. And we want to go ahead and sing happy birthday, okay? So are you ready?
Happy birthday to you.
Celebration, physical birthday, right? January 4th, physical birthday, January 10th, okay? We have a second. Oh, your brother also? His birthday, okay. 14, okay.
Same.
Hospital right now. Okay, so we'll pray for your brother also. So we're going to pray for the cake, okay? But before that, we need to know spiritual birthday. Do you have born again? Okay. Short testimony. Spiritual birthday. What?
When?
Okay. And what do you remember about your birthday? Born again in Christ. What do you remember? I was 18. I didn't know about... Yeah, I was about 18. And I believed I was saved. Okay? And you believed in what? In Jesus as your Savior. Okay? I wasn't involved with witnessing or anything. So who told you about Jesus? I went to church. And there was a lecture. And I saw what was in the Bible. They explained to me. And then I believed in my Savior. And your life changed. And that's good. It proves it's true. And spiritual birthday. She was about 18, 17. Okay. She was sitting in the lecture, and the pastor was preaching, and it convicted my heart. I felt a burden. Make a decision. 100% sure I want to be saved. Pray. Ask Jesus the Lord. Give me salvation. Apply the cross, remove my sin, and live for him all my life. And she was 17. So these two didn't know they had close, same physical and spiritual. She said, I think it was 1996. 93, that's right. Right. So let's pray for the cake. Is it birthday? Yes, I'm birthday. Brother Richard really wants a picture, okay? We have a problem, his battery died, okay? So we're going to use another camera, okay? Or other outside, okay? So we're going to go ahead and eat a little bit of cake. But when we finish, please, we'll have a group picture outside in the light or another picture finish. And back here, we'll go ahead a little bit early start for the preaching, not start time 3 exactly. Okay, we'll start a little bit early, we'll finish early, okay? All right? Father, thank you for blessing us with these two beautiful women here. We pray that you bless and continue to grow her maturity in Christ, and also to grow her maturity in Christ, and sisters together working on a team here in the local church. Help her as a deaf woman, help her as a hearing woman working among the deaf people to both influence their community for your glory. In Jesus' name, bless the food there. So my name is Jim. My name is Joey. Here, have a seat. Thank you. Did you enjoy your day? Oh, yes. Good. How'd you know? What about your life? My life's all right. That's right. Your life's all right. Do you know Jesus? I don't know. We don't know either. Your life will be very negative. How? Hey. What's this pastor talking about? It's not important. My life, I'm independent. Please, stop. We need to change and learn from him. You're stupid. So that guy left, evidently. Okay, don't worry. I'll help explain for you. Okay. I'll pay attention. What do you want to tell me? What do you want me to learn? Good. Your life will be labeled. How? John 4:16, I think is what he's saying. If you see life, how the world says no religion will go to heaven except for through the Father. Oh, no one can go to see the King of Heaven. That's probably what I'm talking about. John 6, verse. Oh, okay, God. So love the world, doesn't matter. will not be perished, but have eternal life. How? How can you have eternal life? If you believe in Christ, you will be saved in your soul. If you don't believe in Christ, your soul will not be saved. Your soul will be lost. What's a soul? We're talking about the heart. The heart? What's a heart? Okay, well, your heart is dark. Why is it dark? Why is that? Dark heart, why? Because we have sin. Why sin? Well, sin, like cheating, stealing, fighting, sexual things, because you do not please God. How sin? Well, really, Jesus Christ knows He wants your life to be changed, to be all right in your soul. Find soul. That's a question. Your life? Where is it today? Our life will be labeled. You don't know where? Who will live? Let me ask you that question. I don't know. James 4, verse 4, I believe it is. See what... Oh, it must be John, Jesus said. It is even a vapor that shows up for a small period of time and then it vanishes and it goes away. How did you find that in the Bible? How did you find that verse? No, it's not me, but God sent me to tell you what the Bible says. Why life? Your life will be gone soon, or consumed. Life? Okay. If you want to accept Jesus Christ, you'll be saved in your soul. Jesus Christ wants your life. Why? Because He doesn't want you to go to hell. How will you know? I don't know. Do you want to go to heaven? So you want to go to heaven, then you got to ask to God, and He can give you new life, a new heart. Oh, wait. Maybe not. Why are you changing your mind? Sin. I want to show you some verses about that. Romans chapter 3, verse 23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Amen. How? If you accept Jesus Christ, you'll be saved. Can't go to heaven. Except for you change, there's a change in your whole, in your soul, in your heart. Jesus wants to save you. Jesus Christ has a plan for you in heaven, a place, a home for you. How? How? A place? Remember, Jesus Christ was crucified, all right? The Roman soldier whipped him. Jesus Christ died for you, for me, because of your sins, and there will be a change. Okay. How did Jesus die? Where Jesus Christ died, and then 3 days later, he rose again. Remember him. Oh, I see. How can I go to heaven? How can I meet in that place? Where is it? If you are saved in your soul, Jesus Christ has a plan for you, a place called home. Oh, I see. Let me see. I like your Bible. I like this. In heaven, we'll show you some verses about heaven. Yes, that's true. I want you to change your soul. I want you to have an all right heart. I want your heart to be washed in the blood for your sins. And you can pray and you can ask to God, forgive me of sin. And then you can have that new life. Okay. I will trust the Lord. I understand my friend left. That's all right. You can pray and ask God, and He will provide it for you. That's fine. Let's pray. Oh, Father, forgive me. I understand this pastor's story. Before I didn't know, I was clueless, but now you've shown me through the verses. Jesus died for me. Really. Forgive me of sins that make wrong things bad, fighting, stealing things bad. I've woken up, take all my sin, and I want to accept Jesus Christ. And I want to serve the Lord. I want to trust the Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. You have been saved in your soul. You have new life. Then you can read the Bible. It's important. What? Pray. Talk to God every day. Go to church. Worship with God. Be with the Father. Trust the Lord. Don't go out in the world. Help with your friends. Because if you know, you need encouragement among your friends. Okay? I'm a true Christian. I promise. I will go to heaven. That's true. I'm going to continue. I'm never going to forget that. I'm not going to go out to the world. I'm going to follow the Lord. I will try to convince my friend. That's good. And then you try to convince not only your friend, but you bring him to my home, and I'll help you. Make sure that we show the verses, okay? Then he'll understand it better. Your heart is all right. Why? Because you'll be fed through the Holy Spirit who's in your heart, God's Word. True. Let me see what you have for a Bible. That's fine. I won't give you it. Thank you. I promise I will never forget. I will just trust the Lord and witness for my friend. Thank you for giving us the Word of God to touch my heart, to convict me. I feel really grieved how Jesus died for me. Forgive me. Oh, it's fine. It's fine. You have salvation. Understand what Jesus Christ has accepted for you. He's applied for you. New life in your heart. Thank you. I understand. Jesus declared to the communities, villages taught, in the synagogues preached the gospel of the kingdom and healed those who were sick and diseased among the people. And that he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered, saying to shepherd, or sheep without a shepherd, excuse me. And then he said to the disciples, the harvest really is plentiful, but the workers are so few. Pray you therefore, the Lord of the harvest, that he will send for workers. I start to suffer.
Church.
I need to know the depth And we have two else. So I understood that I needed to visit. So I was searching, and I found a deaf house, or a person that was deaf, and I visited. Understand, I'm from Hope Baptist Church. So I knocked on the door. So I opened the door and I waved, hi. He invited me.
There we go.
See, you are T. That's my sign name, Scourge. I'm from Church.
Dead church.
Oh, my God. I made a mistake. Again and again. The deaf. Now, they picked on me. Oh, Hope Death Church. And I thank the Lord for how He helps us. All of us need His help. There's no other way. Jesus was doing three things. He was preaching, He was teaching, and He was healing. That's wonderful. If Jesus was right outside, walking along, and a person came, Jesus is right out there. Come on, let's go see. Who of you will go? Of course, all of you are going to go. If someone told you that, I'm going to go too. I want to be close to me. I want to be close to the Lord. Many, many of us want Jesus to heal us. Oh, because he has pain in his knees, pain in his elbows. Many, many people gather together to see Jesus, to hear him preach, to teach, to heal. When I was reading, and I read slow to think about it. Jesus saw many people scared of him. Jesus worked in preaching, teaching, healing, but he waited. All the people were scared. And he could see. He could see to the heart of the people. He saw the scattering of the multitudes. Many, many people. Many times, you and I, we're so busy. Busy. We can't see. We can't understand. People have needs. We need to understand. We need the heart is empty. Because someone needs Jesus. Many times. You and I, we just keep walking, we're busy, 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 working, working. And Jesus was there. He waited patiently to help people. Doesn't matter if it's a long time. Help them. Help. Help. You and I need the same. I was thinking about my life. In the past, I was so busy. And our family wants to go bowling. The children, hey Dad, please, let's go bowling. All right. So we go inside. Crack my knuckles, loosen up, get one of these balls. And you know there's a line that you're not supposed to cross over. Right? You stay behind that line. Know me? I was down there. I'd come right up here. I'd step over the line, and then I would slip, and then I would fall down, and the ball would come. And people would laugh and laugh. Oh. Pain in my knee. Oh. I gotta go to the doctor now. The doctor. So the doctor asked me, how'd you hurt your knee? I was bowling. I'm better at football. How can I hurt my knee? Well, what a dumb way to do that. So the doctor looked at that. You need an operation. I said, no, don't worry. You'll be in the hospital, maybe in an hour. And then you can go home fast. All right. All right. Go to the hospital. They have the surgery. I was asleep, I guess. They finish the operation. And I'm coming to. Where am I? Yes, but there's a bed. I'm in bed. In a room. And I asked the doctor, am I going home today? He says, no. At me, it's all messed up inside. Some sort of drilled holes where blood comes out, make the protection. You need to have
crutches. It's time for crutches. For crutches. Okay.
You have to be on crutches for 3 months. 3 months. I start crying. 3 months. You told me I'll be in and out one day. Finish. I'm sorry. when it occurred, you press the spot and the medicine would come down and go into bloodstream. So I'd push the button. And this is all the, like, you know, it hurt, and I push the button. And it hurts. So I called for the nurse, pushed the button, and the light splashed, and that was the nurse. Watch out. Oh, it hurts. And I'm yelling. She says, oh, settle down. I heard over there, there's another person in the room who's sick. And I could hear them crying out, same as me. I'm crying out. So the nurse finishes, goes over. Calm down. You're going to be all right. Wake up. I cry out, you. Darwin, yes. Darwin, are you in? Oh, yes. I'm in pain over here. I can hear you in pain too. If you die now, will you go to heaven? What a question to ask in the hospital. She said, I don't know. I'm crying out, I don't know. Do you want to know for sure? I don't know. I said that means yes. Sent for my Bible. Reading. Sharing with this guy named God, the gospel. All the people have sinned, finished. And they go to hell. But he calls. Just follow the word. And he will say, first I think of her. I'm thinking about me and crying about my own pain. I'm in the hospital. I don't want to be in the hospital. But God touched my heart. And I read that about the multitude of the people. Jesus helped the multitudes. And I asked myself, I'm in the hospital, why? Maybe to share the gospel with other people. I don't know. And I've changed my attitude completely. When I understand about that, the multitude of people need Jesus. You and I need to live in a way that we can think about other people, not ourselves. The other word we need to think about here is moved. inside it moved. But the meaning is to be touched in the heart. I understand a lot about, I don't understand everything about the Bible, but when I read it, He, Jesus, was touched, moved. Meaning He is the Creator, He, God, He controls all things. He is not touched. I mean, that's confusing to me. It seems like He touches other people. He's not touched. He's the King. He's the King. He's Almighty. But I'm wrong. The Bible truly says He saw the people and He was touched. Wow. You and I are the same. When we go to a restaurant, when we finish, we share from the Word of God. When we finish, I wait. Why? Because I wanted to ask one of the pastors here one question. So I'm waiting. And yeah, I'm patient. Okay. So I asked this question. Pastor, let me ask you a question. So we discuss about this. Almost we're finished. And then the cook. In the kitchen now. He comes down. This is a YouTube pastor. Yes. Could I need to ask you one thing. How do I go to heaven?
Hallelujah.
I want every person to ask me that. Wow. I was so excited. He was excited. So we shared the gospel. We discussed together, finished. But the person, the cook, he didn't trust Jesus, the Savior. So I understood. I needed to give a trap. The other pastor here asked me, Kurt, do you have a track to give me? Me? Why did you ask me that? No, I don't. That can make me. God can make me.
it's overwhelming.
If a missionary doesn't have one track with him to get up to another person, that's crazy. Jesus saw the people multitude and was touched. As I read, remember I told you, I read slow. Compassion.
Are you getting
love, mercy?
Okay.
God's compassion.
Okay. Sure.
Jesus was touched and moved with compassion. Share the gospel with you? No. So I went down to the place where they would eat. Tables. I'm sharing the gospel with people. Do you want to discuss? No, 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 no. Why do I feel I need to go? Submit. I think God touched my heart. But not one person. So I got a break. Sat down and I prayed, God, I'm going to drink when this is finished. One man's name. His name was Tom. And he said, it's the last time. I'm sharing the gospel with people. Discussing. Yeah. All right, I'll sit down here then. Well. I have one bad problem. The problem. Hearing people, or some hearing people, I think is a common stutter. The problem is, try to speak, but it's, I can't, for example, if I'm going to speak. But I try to say, be, so I had a problem. Every word. My father abused her because he was drunk. That started the problem. So I tried to speak to him. We'll never want Jesus to save him. But, listen, for a minute, I asked Tom, do you want to receive Jesus as Savior? Yes. Wow. Not my power, not my strength, it's only that. Dear, no? I'm not right there. Now what do I do? Let's pray. Helped in prayer to receive Jesus as Savior. Peace was in his heart. Later, 1 month, he was chatting, and I asked him, why did you trust Jesus as your Savior? Why? Hurt. I understand before my sin, drugs, sex, sin, singing, drug abuse. I understand. If I rejected Jesus Christ, I pushed him away. I'm crazy. He wants me to forgive him. Wow, that's wonderful. There was another thing. I'm sorry, but you can't say a lot. I know. I thought before if you share the gospel with me, you can't tell me. And then the gospel needs to be the full. That's true. Person, change that person to have peace, to have satisfaction. Hard time to continue, yes. And you get Jesus as your Savior. Change your age. Old, and then now you become young. We continue to go down. Peace. I shared with you about growing up in the church one, right? One day, maybe before, with my heart, it was empty. And I understood I needed something, but I didn't know what. Our church on the corner. So there's a corner where it strips. And there's also a Baptist church opposite. Baptist church. I've heard Baptists teach the Bible. That's all right. That's good. Maybe. He can have it. I had heard the Baptist church for long, long services. The Mormon church service finished. So my mother needed to be working here, helping. So I went over here. The Baptist church. But I'm really shy. I didn't want to go. So there's some dorms. And I just waited, hoping that someone would come up and ask me, can I help you? To understand what I mean. Waiting. The Baptists take a long, long service. Finished. People come out and leave and they scatter. How many people ask me? None. The church there, the Baptist church, they know about truth, the answer, the gospel. How to forgive your sins. One person is standing here, one is begging, help me. One. Standing right here, near your church. People can share the gospel. It was hard for me. He cried. Then God gives us many opportunities to share. A little place to get your hair cut.
Sit down.
Waiting. And then first, when they snip your scissors, you start to witness. Why? Why do you wait? When the person starts to cut, she needs to finish. Maybe 15 minutes to share the gospel. There's no the opportunity to share. Give them a chance. DVDs, ASL things. We understand. Pardon me, thank you. That you're full of mercy. And that you love, compassion. We thank you. Help us to follow you, to serve you. Lord, our charges. Help us to witness. We pray. We start with this. Okay, and also when you go to your barber, you witness only if it's a man barber or a woman barber also.
All
of them. Public places. So, for example, it's not appropriate man, woman, one and one alone.
Okay.
Public place have maybe three barbers seated that way. One woman, two men, cutting. I think a woman's fine because other people watch, not private one-on-one. You think maybe many women have appointment private, they go to home, they sit with one-on-one. It's a different culture of men. Men, they go in place normally with group, with public place, it's different. And I made the mistake long ago in college, I didn't know that, okay? Because I grew up, my mom always cut my hair. So I went to college first time, I made an appointment. I didn't know some places are one-on-one. I didn't know that.
Yes.
But, praise the Lord, that woman barber was military. Strict. Okay. She told me, 5 minutes, finish, go on. I have more people, clients. Go on, go. Finish. Okay. Not a problem.
So maybe I have to share fast.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Share fast.
Okay, no, that's a good question. Why it's not appropriate for woman one-on-one?
Oh, yeah, I love one.
Okay, good. Is that a
misunderstanding? How about people?
Normally, you have people, but I didn't know. Some places you appointment, you schedule, you show up only one-on-one, okay? So, for example, my wife in Chicago, you know black people? Sometimes 8 hours, because they parade, okay? It'd be one-on-one, long time, okay?
Hours.
I didn't know that. Different culture, okay?